nice, but it is.
So Jerry, as you speak about the new album, I know that you were all July, I think, in
yes,
in
Studios
with Terry, our good friend Terry.
Yes,
and you were working night, day and night,
day.
or night and day, or day and night. So can you tell us a few words about the new album, if you can, or
yes. You know, actually, before we even entered studio, mm-hmm. We were working like lunatics from our homes, you know, mm-hmm. with our home studios, mm-hmm. and presenting ideas all members, you know, presenting their ideas, calibrating the ideas. Mm-hmm. So it's a very, very long process. Before even we enter the studio. So I cannot remember another album that we have worked so hard, so very hard. So actually when we entered studio, mm-hmm. And when I entered, you know, and started the recording the guitars with Terry, it was a relief for me. A relief, yeah. Because my mind at this point was ready to explode. So when I recorded, you know, the guitar parts, mm-hmm. that of course are very important for a heavy metal sound.
Okay.
And I finished, you know, the guitars, the guitar recordings. I had the chance to relieve my mind from this direction and focus more on the vocals and the lyrics. You know, the other step, the other necessary step, and the process continues in many levels and in many studios, not only one.
Okay.
Because, for example, recently there were the recordings of the orchestra that happened in Prague.
Okay.
And Chris has this under his control, and he under his he was supervising everything, and so it's also something good for the rest of us. We don't have also to think about the orchestra. Yeah. We have someone focused on the orchestra, and at the same time, you know, I was every day communicating with Spiros. Mm-hmm. I was sending him lyrics. He was making demos with, you know, how he imagines, you know, the vocals, mm-hmm. how he will sing the vocals. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, Cream, our drummer, was traveling in Sweden, record there in the studio in Sweden, the drums. You imagine how it is, you know, when you are divided in three different areas.
Countries.
Yes.
And
everybody, and we work, you know, like ants, you know, collective like ants, you know, all together. So, each member doing his stuff.
I have lyrics, you have vocals, yes. I have the drums.
Yes, so...
this is a good thing.
Yes, we are in a very good place right now, mm-hmm. with the recordings. Most of the parts are recorded. We have a lot of work to do with the orchestra, because there are so many channels, mm-hmm. Over 300 channels of classical instruments.
Oh my God.
you imagine that this must be okay.
Yes.
Put in categories in of instruments, and we must make decisions about which instrument must be louder, you know, stuff like that.
Yes.
And then when we'll finish with this process, and we have also to record the vocals, because we leave the vocals at the end to have as much as possible the final result when we sing. You know, we want to listen to the orchestra.
Yeah.
We want to listen to everything, mm-hmm. and then record the
final part,
the vocals, mm-hmm. and then you know, we make the final strategic decisions when we have everything,
mm-hmm.
and we will send to James Bogren,
okay.
all the stems to do the mix,
mm-hmm.
and then we are over.
You
can relax.
That's good. James Bogren from Opeth, right?
No, James Bogren, producer. The producer.
Yeah.
So we have actually a viewer's question for the same topic.
Ah, hello, Veronica.
I'm appeared. So a question from Russia, from Alexander Smirchov, wants to know, what historic timeline will the new album have, like a past, present, or future?
There is not only one theme in the album. There are themes focused on the present. There are some songs more futuristic, and there are songs that not, I would say, from the focusing on the past, but have mythological elements.
Mm-hmm.
But this time the elements are blended in an occult perspective. So there is, for example, one song. I won't reveal the title. But I will give some hints.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you see the title of the song, you may imagine that it is a song about, for example, a serial killer. You know, it's okay. It's not directing to what it has to say from the first view. But when you read the lyrics, you see that it's quite a different story, and the story is has a lot of Egyptian magical elements,
mm-hmm.
but presented from this timeline, from the present, right now. So imagine someone living right now, using knowledge from the past in order to make something that will affect the future.
Cool.
So
that's actually very interesting.
Yes, so the themes cannot be so easily put in one timeline.
Mm-hmm.
And also I can say that there are two songs that are twins. So it is also the music and the theme is divided. They have their own entity as songs. You can listen to them one at a time,
mm-hmm.
but you will notice that they have some main idea, musical idea behind them,
mm-hmm.
that is evolved from the first song to the second. That it is the big finish, you know, and also the story. You know, you have the first part of the story, and you have the ending.
Yeah.
That was so interesting. I already want to listen to them now.
Yeah, exactly. I'm getting hungry for the new album.
And Alexander had a second question relating to the new album. So, will there be a making of video of the new album?
I think so, because we have a lot of shots, you know, from video and from the orchestra, from the recordings of the orchestra and from the studio. So I believe that, I don't know if we will make it as a documentary altogether, or if we put, part by part, but we have footage to show. So in time, you will find out.
Cool.
But there is footage.
So for now, just have this hint, think about it. So now we are going to some older music, like I saw the Dante's Inverno song, and I was very interested in this. And I'm wondering, how did it fit into your music?
The story of
La Divina Commedia.
It's as I said before, I always wanted to present this story of Dante, because it's really dark, you know, and hellish. And I just wanted the perfect song to present the story. And it was one of my ideas that were never realized until I felt it was the right timing. And with the specific song, I imagined, this actually, this happens in a lot of songs, like for example, with Anubis and Persepolis. I try before connecting the music to the theme. I try to just, I close my eyes and just listen to the music and start like dreaming, like daydreaming, and leave myself, to try to imagine like seeing, a dream. And it comes out, directly. I feel that, this song must have something in this direction. And that was also the case with Dante's Inferno.
Yeah, I imagine.
The difficulty is always to cut stuff out.
Yeah, exactly.
Because when you have such a long story and you have to make only one song, mm-hmm. You understand that it's very crucial what parts of the story to keep to make it coherent,
mm-hmm.
And also make choices for the vocalist to be able
to sing
without telling too many unnecessary stuff.
Definitely, like there are 9 layers. I think there were 9 circles of punishment and so on. So it's like, where is the essence? Like, because it was like a big layer story. But also, what I'm wondering is that for centuries, like translators have been struggling to interpret the poem and write something that it's close to original. So I'm wondering, when you were writing the song and so on, so how did you tackle this difficulty?
How long? I didn't listen to the question.
So what I'm wondering, because if you look at Dante's Inverno, it's very complex. And I know there is an Italian version, but like translators have tried to put a proper translation into English and so on. And
they wrote
notes. So I'm wondering, when you were like doing the song and so on, how difficult was it to understand what the poem was saying? And how difficult was it to put it into a song?
Yes. Actually, I enjoy the process. I enjoy the difficulty because I have the chance to do a research about the theme. It's different to read something casually. Yes, and different to try to understand it, to try to read between the lines. And I also, in the specific case of Dante's Inferno, I also tried to look the Latin, the ancient, writing, and I searched and found some translations. You know, there are differences indeed, and also at some point I was thinking to put some words in the Latin. But it was so difficult to put everything together that I decided, to focus on plot elements. Mm-hmm. I decided to focus in specific zones of hell, to present, the journey. The main character, the journey, and the end. That. It's in the deeper, in the final level of hell. So it was difficult, indeed, but I really enjoyed it.
How long did it take you?
When I work the lyrics, there are months of work, and not of course from morning to night, months. I start today, I make a research, and there are many cases that I did the research and never created lyrics at the end. It's a lot of time consuming. Also with the songs, I wrote a lot of songs that are not in the album, all of us, You have to pass through a process.
Yeah, exactly.
First, that it's a long process, and you don't know if you will use everything or nothing at all, but you have to go through this process, and it's necessary. And this process is really really long process. Mm-hmm. And when you are on the final stage, like I said, and you have to make the final decisions, even then you are working. For instance, now I have one song that some parts are difficult for Spiros, to say with brutal voice. Okay. I have to trim them down. So my work is not ended until the end.